All right, here we are live on Twitch. Welcome, everybody. Today is WhiteFox versus HSG. We're getting them set to go here at the 156 mark. And we've got Doc East and Blitza joining us to commentate today for Squad League. Thanks, guys, for coming and welcome.
Hello, thanks.
So we're going to give you guys this match here, matchup between WhiteFox and HSG. This is winner of this match will take home third place in our tournament. So a very exciting day for us as we come into the final couple matches here for our tournament. Seeing that HSG there with one DC. Go ahead and wait for him. Just give him a moment there.
James, as soon as the game, or as soon as he gets in here, just make sure he goes to you ASAP and fill him in. It wasn't the guy that's going to castle, is it?
So I'll be following HSG here for the first part of this match, and we'll switch over and follow WhiteFox. We'll be on the militia side all day. Usually we're over on U.S. Army, so we just figured we'd cover militia for this match. And yep. We are on OP First Light AAS, calling it down at 100 tickets. And we're just almost set to go here.
Thirty seconds. You got your guy going to castle.
All right, 15 seconds here. Go, 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 queued up here. And there it is.
Yep.
Pretty nice seeing the militia side. Like you said.
All right, James, make sure you got that guy.
Usually end up just kind of coincidentally running U.S. side.
So. Right, yep.
James, make sure you got Castle. Everyone else, Hassle Storage ASAP.
HSG, you hear them on the comms right now. They're focusing as much as they can straight down our storage right away. Like what's it said before in the past past streams, past games. You know, holding storage is pretty paramount. Sooner get there. A lot of times it comes down to whoever gets there first. They usually hold the most advantage.
Yeah, it's going to be an interesting game because we've seen both WhiteFox and HSG on this map in the tournament, and they both played it very well. So not very quite similar tactics. So it's going to be interesting to see how these two match up.
Oh, yeah. See now, too, for the first flags for Train Village for HSG and Train Yard, I believe it is, for WhiteFox. Still sending one person into the capitalist flags.
They would have started by now.
So, that's all the people don't realize, even still, especially in public matches, is it still only takes just one person to capture a neutral flag. So, whenever you're playing those pub games, those of you watching, whenever you got a squad trying to take an entire objective and it's the first flag and you got an entire squad sitting on there, you don't really need to have those guys there. Mm-hmm. Don't use one. Little pro tip. You can see WhiteFox and HSG about to meet that center ridgeline.
Yeah, WhiteFox seems to have slowed down their advance.
Probably
trying to get hold and get HSG from either the side or the rear.
WhiteFox might, if they get the hilltop right there in the center, visible in Babylon and them, if they get there really quickly right now, they're going to have HSG, Spooky, and No, and Axel all them in a very bad spot.
Yeah, it's that that death field that running across there.
I think visible sees him. Yep. No sees him too.
Okay, we see guys at our hills where he's...
Yep, HSG just calls him out.
Yep, and they open fire there.
First blood between, I think it was No and Visible.
Spooky, they're already in the southeast of Eastern Storage.
Spooky, so they're dropping a rally for his squad.
Roger, they're inside the compound already.
Nogo's down there.
It's kind of dangerous dropping a rally that quickly, that close to enemy like that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Very, very easily taken down by, especially Babylon, she should be going down here in a second.
Building on those runes.
If it isn't already. Oh, yeah, it's right there. I see it.
Yeah, and it goes down.
There goes the rally.
Yep, so they are going to be pretty much limited to spawning either at main or fob if that's set up in time. So.
Yeah.
Bad rally location there, but a couple of them still up, moving into storage now.
Looks like WhiteFox have got the advantage, actually, around storage. HSG managed to push in, but they've actually been dropped. A couple of guys just hanging around to the north.
Yeah.
We just lost our rally. They're behind us. I'll mark them.
Any FOB set up initially by HSG?
Not yet.
Nope, just rallies. Hey. Just north. So what? Outside of
set one in Foxtrot 9. So just to the east of Nilrim.
Okay.
Copy.
I got a good feeling off this round. I think it's going to be a good round so far. But these two teams are pushing right now.
Castle.
It's just trying to hold down to the east hill, or the west hills right now. You can see that as well. Them and White Fox both with the squad up there. I don't know if they've recognized each other. I think they have. They're probably about to engage themselves.
We want them to get set up in the east, so I'm going to sweep us through the hills and west.
White Fox winning that eastern ridgeline that feeds into storage. As I said in the past, that ridgeline right there is key to come into storage from the east.
Get in storage.
As long as you control that point over there, you can keep anybody from moving in from the east side and limit the enemy's movement to just coming from that north entrance, that north lane, so to speak.
We need to push storage hard, guys. Get your people inside storage.
Yeah, WhiteFox doing a very good job at the minute of just getting spread out across storage, getting spaced out either east and west, and just stopping that HSG push.
Absolutely. You can see those lanes during the intermission. Blitz and I'll kind of draw this stuff out for you guys. But you can see those lanes really coming into play right now. If you were to zoom all the way out right now, Rusty, you could see. Looking from south and north.
Spooky, you guys good
yep.
out there?
See what I'm talking about. You can see out to the east, HSG moving down that eastern spine.
Yep.
On the center of the map, HSG coming from the north and also from the west. So those are the three lanes you kind of want. I kind of speak of when I talk about lanes onto storage. So obviously you don't want to run through those clear open fields because you're not going to have a good time compared to running through those forests.
Down to 296 tickets for White Fox at this first little engagement.
284. Here for HSG.
Right up against the wall.
James, when you spawn on your rally, I need you to get an FOB up.
Copy that.
Hardstyle's there with an FOB call. Says it's just about time for us to get one up.
Yeah, they were kind of. It's just kind of running out of steam now. You can kind of see that now too.
Copy. We are now.
Yeah,
the issue is we need you guys
sorry,
massively
though.
Over here.
No, just HSG going to struggle here because practically everyone's down.
We have no gun.
There's no squad up that can get that FOB placed at the minute.
Yeah. They're kind of running out of momentum and steam. This is where WhiteFox they can really seize the moment. I mean, they're obviously noticing this kind of lull
squad
in the pressure from HSG right now.
Northwest.
Once they realize that and kind of are smart enough, or I mean, maybe their tactic is just holding the storage right now and just kind of grind them out, let HSG throw themselves at them.
Like right there on those.
But now would be a good opportunity for them to push north.
Copy that.
And try and get a hold of store or castle rather and push out.
Spooky, are you guys down?
But then again, like I said, that might be WhiteFox's plan to sit tight.
North, we're cleared them up and we're reviving each other now.
Yeah. I mean, at this stage of the game, you know, sort of the first 5 minutes into it, you can't really push too aggressively with not knowing where the fobs are. At this stage of the game, there isn't one, but you know, WhiteFox don't know that at the minute.
Right.
So, you know, until you get a feel of where that FOB is, that FOB is and what direction they're coming in from, and then you can gauge where you're going to push and where
definitely.
You're going to hold.
And push up.
Definitely.
I see a lot of HSG spawning on that northwest side now. Does that fob go up, did it?
Finally, yes.
Yep.
Where were they streaming out of right there? Right northwest of the bend of the road. About Charlie 4 in the vicinity. They placed a fob there. But granted, that could also be kind of a dangerous placement, too. I mean, if I were WhiteFox and I try to take that lull, or if there is another lull, for example, using these woods out to the west is a very... Using that lane, that western lane, is a very good good way of moving up on the next objective.
Yeah, you certainly don't want to leave that lane open. If you're going to successfully assault that castle there, you pretty much have to come from both sides.
Right. And it's same goes to castle, or same goes to storage. You know, trying to take storage from any direction or at all. You really have to control those terrain, eastern and western hills, or one of them at least, to get a way in there.
You know, and especially once White Fox is inside storage, if they start taking a lot of heavy fire from the west, it's just going to push them east out towards their capture objective, and then that's usually when we see that double neutralization of those flags, is when these teams, they pick a side, they pick a lane, then they go out strong, and they basically just swap sides with each other, and they take each other's objectives, and then you get that double neutralization there.
I've marked them on the map.
I mean, you'll see, too, I mean, look how strong the HSG push is right now to the west in those western hills. You know, since their fob is up there, they're automatically, White Fox is going to realize really quickly there's enemy fob in that direction, with the amount of guys that are coming from that direction. It's also, White Fox is going to also mass a lot of their guys on that side as well to kind of plug that hole.
Spooky, leaving guys in contact right there?
White Fox with the idea of, hey, you know, they're pushing this many resources on this side, they got to have a weak spot someplace else. That's when you send out, you know, four or five guys to go either try and ninja cap something or work their way around.
Mm-hmm. And there was a guy behind. You can see Connor and Reddick there coming in from the east side, 100%. Just getting a lot of pressure on them. While Rain Bubbles and Rainbow Blue are pushing up, trying to get eyes on that FOB on that west side. It's a good play by White Fox so far. They're doing a really good job of just meeting that push and stopping in its tracks.
Yeah, that's what they're doing right now.
Castle now
a lot of it is you just plug in those holes, you know. Like you said, stopping them in their tracks. You know, stopping them before they get anywhere close to being able to maneuver on you in the first place.
Heartstall being where there's
292 tickets for White Fox.
253 here for HSG. Yeah, these White Fox guys here in the western woods, west of storage here, very accurate on these HSG guys spawning in. A lot of these guys going down here.
A massive gap in the kills as well now between the two clans. White Fox really pulling away with 41 kills and only 8 deaths across the team.
You can see out to the west right now. You see HSG, Ruthless Noodle, and Vitali out there. What they're kind of doing is kind of plugging a hole. They're expecting White Fox guys to come around to the west side. That's what they've got those two little sensors, sensor players out here for. So they're looking for any kind of movement, and it's exactly what White Fox is doing. You can see right next to him, no more than 100 meters away, is White Fox's three guys.
Spooky, what do you got, man?
So they're about
just watching Castle pick.
Like I said, plug in those holes. HSG's doing that.
West side of you guys.
Looks like they might slip right past him. Yep. Look at that. White Fox's guy slipping right past looking for that fob.
Yep,
HSG's
absolutely.
Ruthless and Vitali missing him.
Alright, I hate to be that guy, but
that's one of the beauties of squad is that concealment factor, you know, you're just seeing that there.
The only way.
Guys running 80 meters away from each other, not even seeing because of that concealment and how hard it is to identify your targets.
That's why it's smart for, you know, holding your fire for a lot of times as well, especially for White Fox, for Rain, Bubbles, and Rainbow right now, holding their fire right there. They could have seen those HSG guys right there. As long as they didn't see them, just don't fire. Sneak by, see what kind of trouble you can make behind their lines, either on their fob or whatever, because it looks like they're about to find it. Those three White Fox guys.
They've got eyes on.
Yep, there they go. They're engaging them.
The fob's getting overrun. We have optics.
Yeah, and then we hear that call from HSG there. Fob's getting overrun.
Roger.
Yep, that's White Fox, Rain, Rainbow, and Bubbles right now coming in from behind. Slipped right past that little those sensor guys, Ruthless and Vitali out there. You get disciplined not to fire on those guys and just slip right through.
Now we're down to 232 tickets here for HSG.
Still at 290 for White Fox.
They're slowly creeping out of storage. I don't know if you guys can see that right now.
I'm going to try and take out this fob and move it.
On Castle.
Storage. White Fox.
They're creeping up from storage. I think that's what you mean.
Yeah.
They're creeping out of the White Fox.
To get on that fob
very consistent push here. They're not doing any sort of, you know, you guys hold down the line and we'll sneak some guys around and rush in on Castle. They're kind of all focused on a front line here, except for those three guys going behind their fob there. But for the most part, focused on either side of the road here. And a very consistent push here on HSG from White Fox.
Yeah, it's good work by White Fox. As Docky's pointed out, they felt that pressure coming in hard from the northwest. And just really just plugged it and pushed in from there just to get eyes on what was causing it. They found the fob.
Yeah, HSG's panicking right now. They're talking about digging it up. Spook and Hardstyle's talking about losing that fob on it. Yeah, they're about to lose it. They're dropping down a secondary fob. It's spawning from main now. HSG.
Just drop it air.
Push back hard.
Gonna kind of hurt him.
You can drop one. All right,
I'll throw it down
here.
Because the amount of time it's gonna take their guys to push out of main and get to castle and/or storage right now. White Fox has got a very good push all the way down to castle before they even get anybody there.
I got you. Cover me.
So it's gonna take a second for HSG to kind of collect themselves and rally here and get things put back together. Let me just use, they're gonna try and dig up that fob.
Thanks. Fuck.
Oh, they might dig it.
Right, dude. I just saw him right out the corner of my eye.
It's Spooky, Jericho, and Noah over here on the that eastern ridge, trying to presume get a neutralization on storage, just trying to flank round.
He's across the way.
Get situated, but
I don't even know how the fuck he saw me.
Might be a little bit too late. They're not making enough progress quick enough.
All right.
We're within 400 meters right now.
Yeah, HSG really jammed up in this one spot here, and they're pushing medics in trying to get these guys up, but they're taking effective fire from almost every single angle, and it's just impossible for these medics to stay covered while they try to get these guys back up here.
I'm taking this fob down right now.
Copy.
HSG pulling down that fob. I thought they were going to lose it there for a second.
I'll try to keep this this neck of the woods secure if you guys want to try and push up to storage.
It looks like they've got enough numbers in just to hold it there, enough guys up.
Squad 3 handle storage for now. We're going to play defense on castle. You guys need to get that fob and then push storage.
Very good comms from HSG. Very consistent, very...
Fob's down.
Very concise and clear.
Push storage hard. Push storage hard.
Absolutely nothing from White Fox.
Yeah, they're known for that. They like talk to each other with smoke signals.
Alright, castle's still 100%, guys. We're fine here.
Morse code with flashlights, right?
Yeah. Running through the woods with flashlights.
I'm going to take my squad from the fob and push to storage.
Spooky, go farther south, please. Farther south.
Just on those three that I pointed out, Jericho, Spooky, and they're actually coming in now from the southeast on storage.
You want to build another fob?
Starting neutralization. White Fox got mostly still up.
Behind storage.
Yeah, HSG, they're placing a fob behind storage. Very sneaky little move right here. Those three guys down by storage right now. They pull this off. They're going to drop down, drop a fob first before they push that attack. That might scare White Fox enough. Yep. Exactly what Hardstyle's
called. Well, HSG, they do have a fob there in,
I'm taking my guys from the fob.
It looks like Golf 6, keypad 1 there. You can see him spawning in now.
They better get some more guys on storage, though. I mean, they can't really devote that many resources down to push storage right now with the tidal wave of White Fox that's coming into castle right now.
Yeah, you guys should be good down there.
And especially once they do enter into storage, Mostly is going to give that signal, that smoke signal over to the rest of his White Fox guys, and they're going to know that HSG's down there in storage, and we'll see how many guys they end up turning back from this attack on castle.
Where do you see them at storage?
Yeah, just guys on HSG guys on castle right now. They're really gonna have to dig deep in order to hold this. As I'm guessing, blue rain and mist out to the northwest. White Fox are gonna place a fob, and it's just gonna be a stream in the castle from here on out. So HSG's playing though. Hardstyle, his call was to push into castle or storage right now. Drop that fob, push into storage, and try to pull pressure off of castle right now. I might pull off.
Get into storage, boys. Get into storage. Surround that shit.
I'm just thinking it's a little bit too late. Spooky and No have actually pushed out further west onto the hills. Where the 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 west onto the hills.
And. One. More second. One ticket.
All right. Sorry about that, guys. Just had a B-sod there. Not sure what's going on. But you can see there, White Fox pulling away with the first victory.
Nice, guys.
We're going to go ahead and go to intermission here and kind of talk about some tactics here. And we'll be back up and running here shortly and back for round two. What was the, 226. What's
126?
126 ticket. That's going to be pretty hard for HSG to come back there against 126 tickets.
Definitely. It's possible. It's going to be difficult, but it's possible. Be able to come back.
All right. I'm just gonna
We can type those in.
Just gonna open up that that link that you got.
Okay.
Yeah, so HSG pulling away there, or WhiteFox rather, pulling away, gets the first win for round one. So HSG could still come back, but that's going to be pretty hard for them to come back against 126 tickets there. Yeah, very strong showing there for WhiteFox. So what do you think? For round two? Which we're switching up sides, so HSG will be U.S. Army, WhiteFox on Militia, so switching up the different sides, but I don't know. What do you
think? I think it'll be about the same, especially old tactics-wise. We can kind of go over what HSG and WhiteFox did,
okay.
Respectively.
Sure.
And kind of point that kind of stuff out for people to see. I guess we can take turns, I guess. For HSG, the way they pushed out, you know, they placed one man down into... and the same thing goes for WhiteFox. They placed, like I said, one actual guy to take that first point. But after that, they pushed down... HSG, they kind of took a little bit shorter route. Instead of taking the center ridgeline, which is incredibly important, as well as these western sides, these are the three lanes I talk about when I talk about lanes on OP First Light. With HSG pushing down that center ridgeline, they didn't quite push down that center ridgeline completely. One second, I'm just going to figure out how to clear my stuff. Oh, I reset all of them. So they pushed down straight out of main. And headed this direction, roughly, which gave WhiteFox the opportunity to come up directly from the south and pretty much cut off that first squad on that side, as well as breaking some guys off to push around that west side. So we saw that early in the round, which is pretty classic. It's pretty traditional. I don't know what you saw on your end, Blitzer.
Yeah, so essentially, like we said, WhiteFox just pushed the one guy to the first cap, and then he took up this position here, bang in the center. And what that allowed them to do is, from that position, shoot on HSG and essentially pulled HSG to their position, which is what you want to do. Bring them to you, especially when you've got the height. So from that point, they were managed to clear the HSG there, the squad, and wipe that rally. So remember, there was a really dodgy rally they set up.
Yeah.
Which caused HSG to spawn at main. So that was a whole squad, essentially, which were out of the game for the first 3 minutes.
Yeah, so, definitely. And it took them a while, too, to place that first fob, HSG.
Yeah. So WhiteFox, you had pushing from main up to there. And then you had a squad pushing all the way in, leaving one on the second cap. And then you had another squad pushing those west hills. So they almost mirrored each other, except WhiteFox had the advantage on that center ridgeline with the circlers, which I put there.
Definitely. Yeah, they locked that center ridgeline down. And like I said, you know, that center ridgeline is very, very, very key. For pretty much the entirety of the round, pushing the center ridgeline and pushing storage, like I said, there's three different avenues to attack storage from. You know, you've got the center ridgeline, you've got the north side, and also the west side, as well as this position here, this center ridgeline that runs parallel with perpendicular rather with storage itself. Pushing guys directly into this point and holding this point down, you block that whole avenue of approach, whatever enemy comes from the north and or south. So that was very key for WhiteFox to lock that down early game. So the five placements now is, but yeah, that's the ones I saw for HSG.
Yeah, so I put the two down that were there for WhiteFox, and that's pretty much the next turning point, is that North HSG FOB.
Yeah.
Ghost got into that really quickly. Once that FOB was up and HSG started pushing, you just saw WhiteFox flood that direction. They reinforced from the east. They had guys pushing from their fob. And really got the pressure on them. Managed to take that fob out. And, you know, the first 5 minutes of the game, losing a fob is bad news.
Yeah, well, that also, too, HSG, you know, they hadn't placed any fobs until they placed this one. And that was a good... That wasn't until most of their guys that were pushing storage in the first place were all wiped. So by then, HSG had figured out where the pressure was coming from. Or HSG, I'm sorry. WhiteFox figured out where the pressure was coming from, and they pushed up here, like you said. And then overpowered them, pushed through, and then basically followed this road all the way straight down. And that brings to the next point, too, the next little portion around or act of this play, or this round here. Once they pushed through that fob, WhiteFox, I mean, yeah, I'll let you go over that, I guess.
No, it was just pretty straightforward. Once they'd taken that FOB down, the numbers were there, no resistance. You've just taken a fob, so they just sweeped straight in. HSG having to spawn from main, so as soon as that was neutralized, they then pushed in from there straight onto castle and got the bodies in. castle's always a hard one to take because you're so close to main for militia.
Yeah, that's when we saw those three guys that you said that you know they could have gotten straight into storage from HSG.
Yes.
They looped all the way around and got to this position and dropped this fob. And while WhiteFox was pushing this objective here and taking castle, majority of them are spawning back in main because they had no other options. They dropped down south, dropped this fob, and pushed into castle. And that's when we saw that double neutral happen right there.
Yeah, yeah.
So you can see both teams throwing all their might into each side there, trying to capture each other's points, with both points or both teams having all of their guys on each side, you know, thus bringing along that double neutral there.
Yeah. And then the one that put the nail in the coffin for HSG was this and this, being so close proximity to each other.
Definitely.
HSG obviously having the shorter route into storage, but, you know, they're not checking south, which is where WhiteFox pushed up, got pressure on the FOB, and they lost them tickets.
Definitely. They just happened to find that objective, that fob as well, the WhiteFox guys, because as they were coming in to go reinforce storage, they just happened to run this direction.
Yeah.
And just literally just stumbled across that fob and then killed it.
Yep.
And that was 10 tickets right there, you know. You got to kind of be aware of what's around you, you know. It, of course, that was just blind luck, you know, that they had placed it there and the WhiteFox guys just kind of stumbled across it. But...
Right. Yeah, it was pretty much on their way to storage. They had to go through that area.
Yeah.
So just on how we're going to go second round.
Let me clear all these icons really quick. Oh, we cleared all the icons.
Right, that's okay. So essentially, HSG have got to do better to control these areas. First round, WhiteFox took the initiative. They took those areas across the ridge, west side, and really get on the front foot, even push the north if they have to, and just get that buffer set up around storage, because they didn't do that well enough first round. WhiteFox really beat them to it, but then there was no real aggressive push to take that landscape back, that terrain.
Definitely. And it's the same way going from the north as well. You know, a lot of times you'll see squads come straight down this ridgeline and then run into contact right here. It's where we see a lot of the first contact. It's always that center ridgeline right there. Because we're the, you know, it's a very key position because, like I said, it's kind of a crossroads for the entire map.
Right,
yeah.
You can push any direction from that center ridgeline. Let me clear all that crap out of the way.
You don't want to get in the habit of flanking to the corners of the map because you really... only have a couple options, whereas if you're coming down the middle, you can retreat any way that you like, whereas if you start pushing yourself into those corners, you know, your only way out is to come either, you know, to retreat back, you know, or just push through anything that's going on. So yeah. Definitely a good play for WhiteFox to come and control that middle ground. We'll see what HSG does with this turn, changing of sides, if they decide to, you know, push on storage directly, or if they decide to kind of set up their base there in the middle of the map and then branch out from there.
Yeah, and like Blizzard said, you know, you get to this ridge right here, and you watch, it doesn't matter which sides you're on, you watch south, or if you're on the south side, you watch north, you can catch, and you sit there and wait, you will more than likely catch somebody coming from this direction or this direction. You know, there's many times where I've been able to set up ambushes from this spot right here.
Yeah.
And you can easily wipe an entire squad every time. You know, if the other team's not aware of that point and isn't taking those precautions to stop that from happening.
And that's what set the momentum for the game, was WhiteFox taking that position and wiping that HSG squad, and that really, really pushed that momentum for WhiteFox.
Yeah. Again, you know, you hold those lanes, you hold these lanes here, and you put guys in positions to keep people from moving down these lanes here, here, and here, you will stop any kind of threat that will come pushing into the actual objective itself. And this goes for every objective in every single map in the game. You know, you stop the enemy here, they won't have a chance to get here.
All right, so almost about ready to get going here. I'm just talking to these guys, getting them ready to go. Coming back from intermission. I like this map feature. If you guys like this as well, just let us know in the comments there if you like seeing us discuss the intermission here. Because we might I don't know about it. We might start doing that on YouTube, just having one video. Kind of gets confusing when you split up the videos and people are like, which one's which?
Yeah.
So if we can run a good intermission, might as well just have it all in one video.
Yep. Kind of an idea we all had to kind of come together. Because I know all you viewers out there, you know, you guys see what's going on the map. You see the action. But then you hear what the commentators are talking about. Like, oh, hey, they're pushing this objective. You know, they're doing this. But, you know... it's only half of the information. You know, I know personally myself, I'm a visual learner, and I'm sure there's a lot of other people too. And having this visualization kind of paints a picture of what's going on instead of saying, hey, you know, they're pushing left, you know, and when on screen you see two guys running around the side of a mountain. Like, you have no idea what the overall context of that actually is.
Right.
So that's what we're trying to capture here for you guys. Let you guys see that. So let us know. Somebody let the chat know that we were had some technical difficulties.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll have to dive into that more. I haven't had a BSOD in so long. It's weird.
I have never had a BSOD. Like, ever.
Yeah, I'm trying to look into it. It looks like it was a memory error or something.
I remember the only time that I had VSOD was when overclocking my CPU and trying to make it stable.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to run mem test after this. I have some bad memory or something. All right, so we'll be following WhiteFox.
The meme test.
Yeah, meme test or whatever, mem test.
So there's a meme test.
These guys switched up here.
Best.
Yep.
Check that link on TeamSpeak.
Yeah, that's what I've used before. I'm gonna have to use that.
No, seriously. How you
use it? I'm seeing. Oh, I actually didn't know that. Oh, that's. That's kind of funny.
I'm watching the stream. I'm not seeing.
Yeah, you didn't have the map up.
There you go. So it went.
It's,
okay,
it's switched.
Oh, oh yes.
I was like, oh Jesus.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Typical Rusty. I really like. I'd feel more comfortable if I had like 12 monitors, because it's just like I'll have to take a picture of it. But behind OBS, there's like 40 stacked windows. Give these guys 2 minutes here before we get going for round two. Again, if you're just joining us, this is our third place match. So the winner of today's matches is going to claim the title as the third place contestant here for our first tournament for Squad League. Grand final will be on April 30th. It'll be against... that'll be the Ghost Clan versus the Redcoats.
Yep. So it's going to be good trying to see what WhiteFox does this time around as far as working from the opposite side now. So it's the same way with HSG, seeing them push down from the south. Again, though, we'll see the same thing about on the first objective as you'll, you know, majority of the time see the same plan for everybody, because kicking that first guy after those first objectives is all you need to cap those flags. You don't want to, you know, spend that much resources, so to speak, pushing that many guys down to those first flags when there's absolutely no reason for them to be there. And all you need is one guy to cap that point. You know, it is, you know, sometimes you'll see teams rush those objectives. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Most of the time it doesn't.
Right.
But you always see that first flag taken by the first guy, or one guy.
Getting ready for round two here. Excited. You guys are good. It's a good matchup here. Seconds away here.
Oh, what? WhiteFox using local chat? I didn't know they talked. I'm down over top of them right now.
Yeah. All right, here we go. So, following WhiteFox here for this match.
Okay, so just a pointer here from HSG. They haven't spawned the whole team in. They've got initial squad going out. Two guys out to cap the first. Oh, sorry, one guy for the first. So I can imagine they're going to do this fob hop thing that people like to do.
Come on, to Tapel.
Just purely for that stamina advantage, pushing into storage.
Put down the man. Sacre bleu.
Do you understand me?
Okay, yeah, HSG's fob is down, and the team are spawning in now, heading towards storage.
White Fox leaving one back at castle to cap.
Yep, also valid tactic. Them pushing castle is near impossible from the position that they're in, HSG. So those first couple flags, you can most of the time, 99% of the time, get away with that. White Fox pushing a small squad of that center ridge line that we pointed out before, and they're crossing that open field. That's might not be a good position for them. HSG stacking guys up in that very center of the map, like I pointed out. If they get guys in that ridge line and watch north right away, those White Fox guys are not going to survive very long.
I think HSG have hesitated a little bit there and hesitated to go up, and I think White Fox actually going to manage to get into cover before they get eyes on.
Yeah. They might get a couple of them here. Oh, HSG sees them. Be very difficult for those for Super Metal or Sub Metal, bringing that split in Babylon down there. To hold from those HSG guys in the center ridge line right there. All they have to do is just push down that ridge to the west, and they can push them straight off of that every time.
Babylon goes down there. White Fox guys getting pushed from both sides here.
So they're fighting the same three lanes. You got a couple guys up to the west on those western hills. Some White Fox guys coming in from the very north, straight into storage, and trying to trickle into the east. But HSG kind of has those hills on lock right now, if they can finish wiping those guys. White Fox about to cap storage. Or storage, I'm sorry, castle.
Yeah, there you can see there. Nilrim captured by HSG. White Fox gets the castle.
So the battle for storage starts now.
Absolutely.
And this is why it's so imperative to get that first contact of storage in your favor, because you know the caps are going to fall, and you need to get in and get that advantage in hard cover.
Right.
White Fox have got that initiative at the minute. Very quiet on commander comms for the minute for HSG.
Yeah, same with White Fox. They were very, very vocal, HSG was last round, so.
And again, if you're just joining us, this is round two of White Fox versus HSG, third place match here for Squad League. And White Fox pulled away with that first round one victory, 126 ticket difference there. So going to be hard for HSG to come back on them. And the winner of these rounds is going to be the third place champ for our tournament.
Well, you can see White Fox locking down that center ridgeline that feeds into the inner storage from the east. And they've got enough guys on top of that thing right now. But there's also an HSG squad coming from the southwest trying to feed into the center of that map. From where they're at right there, it's a very good position to shoot down the axis of that hill, or that center ridgeline to the west in storage, and killing those guys.
I think the tale of the two teams here is the breakup of forces. White Fox very good at staying connected. You know, not getting too spread out across the squads, apart from when they need to push east and west for storage. HSG look a little bit dotted. I think, you know, losing that initial momentum on the terrain as it was in the first round is sent them a little bit wavy. Almost drip feeding into this contact here, and you know, almost doing what they did to Fubar in their first game, and you know, Fubar very spread out. That's what's happening to HSG now.
Yep. Looks like White Fox is just slowly pushing him back out of there. They have storage on cap right now, and they've got a pretty solid hold on it right now. Out to the west, that White Fox squad pushing south, pushing HSG back, keeping those ridge lines on lock. But they're not doing so well on the east side, the center end of the map. HSG just kind of has a control on that side.
Very few forces up for HSG in and around storage. Everyone's been dropped. People are coming in from main. People coming in from the FOB now, southeast. You can actually see White Fox now breaking out south and southwest of storage, looking to get poised, ready for the next push.
Yeah, same thing with White Fox. They got a couple guys just south of storage right there trying to stop any kind of push directly from the south, from Nilrim Village. It looks like they're going to plant themselves pretty well here. Let's see the HSG guys from the south catch them off guard. Pretty good little fight going off to the east as well, too, on the center ridge. You know, both sides really trying to hold that side. Again, trying to plug those holes. You can see, you know, take note, nobody likes to move across those open fields because it's just straight suicide. So, again, with using those lanes. Looks like a FOB squad, a FOB planting squad. Rain, Nathan, and Furious from White Fox kicking out to the southwest.
Yeah, this is everything we're seeing here now, Doc East, is what we always harker back to in the, once you get that objective capped, push out and get them front set up, because effectively what White Fox are doing now are skirmishing with HSG and stopping them trying to get a concise effort push on storage just by breaking up the lines, getting them in a little bit of firefights here and there.
Yeah. I also need to bring up too, after we do another little analysis like we did during the intermission of this last round, Rusty's going to be doing a key giveaway as well. I don't know if you mentioned that.
Yep, absolutely. Thanks for reminding me.
Down to 252 tickets here for HSG.
287. White Fox. So HSG really doing a good job plugging that hole in that center ridgeline like I was talking about. Stopping them from using that and going further to south and looping around on a nil rim. So by having those guys where HSG has them nil, stopping White Fox, it covers nil rim from that direction. Unless those White Fox guys want to take a crazy big detour all the way around, which you hardly ever see. It's just kind of crazy.
You'll be fine, man.
So they're really keeping the pressure up on that west side, or the east side. I'm sorry, west. My camera turned around.
Thank you.
Absolutely no comms from White Fox. Being all mysterious, like always.
Yep.
Same here for HSG. I've got nothing at the minute.
A little bit on local here from White Fox, though.
Yeah, they were talking to local in the very start of the round.
Yep.
But after that, they switched to hand signals, or however they do it.
Incoming message!
They're up there with flags standing on top of a hill.
Yeah. No, it's red, then blue! These are coming from the west, east, I don't know! Yeah, I really do appreciate the communication system that the devs have implemented. It just works so well. You know, that's why they didn't change it from PR.
Absolutely.
Having the tiered, the vocals, having the local up to the squad chat, up to the commander chat. It's just it's a robust and simple communication system, and it works.
Yeah, that's my favorite part about it. It's just so simple, but it's exactly what you need.
And then now people come from Arma 3. I mean, you know, people that have been playing competitive Arma and stuff, they'll probably be familiar with Acre. You know, Doc, you being a U.S. veteran, is it kind of similar to what you have on the field, where you have your 343, your personal radio, and then maybe your, 143 or something like that, that you've got your squad commander radio or something like that? Is that similar, where you have your squad radio and then you have your commander radio?
It depends on the situation. But, I mean, it's usually just, you know, just channels and stuff like that. And it's the same way, same thing Acre does. You know, you can go so in-depth with a lot of stuff, but that's a totally different game, obviously. But it's the simplicity that squad brings, you know, is what I love about it personally. I mean, you don't need any fancy, you know, crazy 256 radio channels and frequencies, and you don't need to spend 20 minutes to do that. You know, just hop right in, get to the action. But it's still serious enough that you know you can't go running a gun in.
Exactly, you need that communication.
The WhiteFox pushing him back now. You can see WhiteFox broke through HSG on the east. If you span out right now and see that. You see WhiteFox pushing down to the northeast of Nilrim. That's what HSG was trying to stop, but looks like they pushed through it, and they're working their way around. Another point on how important that center ridgeline is. So now HSG has to worry about WhiteFox coming from that direction as well as the west and north. You can see HSG kind of consolidating back on top of the cap, giving WhiteFox free reign to kind of maneuver where they want and come in any direction they want.
283 tickets here for WhiteFox. How are we looking on the HSG side?
We're at 220 for HSG.
Yeah, so WhiteFox really pulling away here. First round victory and then coming out very strong here in round two.
Yeah, WhiteFox really now starting to pinch HSG onto Nilrim Village here. Although a little ninja squad out to the west for HSG. Three boys pushing out west. I'm trying to get an FOB set up ready for a push back onto storage.
.279 WhiteFox.
.217 HSG. Another thing I picked up on both rounds, WhiteFox on OP first sight, very good at getting that group up push, so pushing as a unit and pushing the enemy back really, really far. They're doing a very good job of that.
That's what you need for all of the maps, and oftentimes you'll see small onesies and twosies do things like that, and it never really comes to fruition as far as pushing objectives and, you know, trying to pull off different moves and maneuvers and whatnot. Especially on OP, you know, you have squads grouped up together like that, an entire squad pushing down that east side where HSG, where Hardstyles and everybody is, pushing all the way around it in Nilrim, is a very good push. Same thing with the west side. You keep your squad together, you keep all those weapons to bear, more opportunities, more sensors, more people looking for things, more bodies to capture a point, specifically, and just overall more power pushing through an objective. Having everybody together just changes things.
Definitely. Mm.
Having all the kits all working together, because, you know, having all those different kits kind of work together. Kind of, they do.
Yeah, they're all put there for a reason.
Exactly. So you put them all together, you put a squad lead with what's going on, and, you know, you put those actual squad mates playing those classes to their strengths.
Yep.
The way they're supposed to be played, and also working that and tying that into conjunction and giving that squad leader those kind of capabilities, and, you know, staying on objective, staying on mission.
Yep.
You know, will change the tide of a match. You know, you win those small little battles with those squads and those teams, those clan mates playing, or, you know, squad mates playing together, giving that squad leader those kind of options, and you win those small little battles, and overall you win the entire round. So it's literally comes down to every single person playing like a team, thinking about what's going on, playing their strengths and weaknesses. You know, each little battle and sums up to be the sum of the entire battle. So.
And that's also where you start to gain that satisfaction from playing. You know, it can be intense and sometimes frustrating when you're playing during battles. You know, if the battle's not going your way and you're struggling, but you play through stuff like that. And if you all work together, I think you'll find that teamwork really prevails. And, you know, if like your riflemen go down, you know, good luck having the medics trying to cover. each other, trying to get them back up. You know, that's a job for your ARs. And if everybody's doing their job and working together, you know, that's when at the end of the round you kind of kick back and you're like, all right, you know, we've got our teamwork moving, we've got our mojo, and you know, now you're practicing those tactics and starting to hone your skills.
Yep, you're only as strong as the rest of your squad. You know, yep. Coming from a squad leader standpoint and looking down the rest of your guys, you literally only have enough power, only have the power when the rest of the squad gives you that power to use in the first place. You know, the squad leader, you're kind of a catalyst, you're a means to the end. You know, moving a squad around and doing things, you know, you're leading that squad. If you have squad mates that don't listen and go off and do their own thing, you know, you're, like I said, you're only as powerful as your squad mates in your squad. You know, so that's why lone wolves, really, you really do not need to be lone wolfing, because you give, you know, you kind of rob your squad leader and your entire team of that capability.
Up a pretty successful backwards push here from HSG. They've got a couple members to flank around the backside of storage, and they're causing trouble for White Fox guys. Running out of the backside of storage here.
Yeah, I was just going to highlight them, Rusty. HSG were in sort of groups of 2 and 3, and you saw a big push from White Fox to neutralize that, and there was 7 or 8 guys pushing as a unit, and that's been the difference across these two rounds, and that's why HSG have suffered the casualties they have. Because they're just not, they haven't grouped up enough when they've been moving across terrain, as we highlighted earlier.
252 tickets here for White Fox. How is our ticket count over there for HSG?
186 for HSG.
186, all right. 86 tickets left here. Yeah, it's all but a few White Fox guys skirmishing here on the east side of Nilrim. Mostly
yeah, White
in
Fox
of HSG.
Doubling back. Yeah, White Fox doubling back and wiping off that that HSG squad that somehow worked around to the north behind it. Looks like they're finally kind of creeping their way out now. HSG's able to kind of push out. I'm guessing they've got a fob somewhere to the southwest. No fobs for White Fox. Actually, I haven't seen a fob this entire round. Have you? Rusty?
I don't believe so. Because HSG guys did, they caused enough disruption to break off a little bit of a force here from White Fox to go back and check Castle. So we can see these three guys here working their way back to Castle to make sure that cap has been untouched by HSG. That they're not
getting. Yeah, it's a smart move.
Yep, absolutely. So HSG pulling forces off. Looks like they're turning around though, coming back there.
But that's kind of a mind games play right there, and it can work. I've done that before as well. You know, sneaking those guys back where HSG is at, it only really take one person to do it. You make enough noise and make enough of a problem up there, you're going to make whatever team's defending think twice and pull some guys off of the cap that you're trying to currently push and stop them from pushing up north, which gives your guys the ability to get into the cap like Axel and Fisticuffs are doing right now. So, that's a plausible idea there. Cause enough ruckus in one spot, pulling pressure away from one spot and pushing in the weak area.
Right.
So, this is a distraction, more or less.
HSG really are burning tickets here, down to 168 already.
Medic's here, don't give up. Rainbow, get him up.
Yeah.
I'll heal the rest.
I need a bandage. No bandage, no bandage.
Okay. Copy that.
Wait.
The thing I've noticed as well with White Fox, so when they move across the terrain, very efficient. They have a point man, and then you sort of have a group of two or three, and then a rear guard, essentially. So if anyone comes into contact, you've got a second and third wave, essentially, coming into that firefight, and it's they're reaping the benefits here against HSG. They really are just pushing across this terrain.
...240 tickets here for White Fox.
162 for HSG.
Yeah, very spread out here for both teams. I think we tend to see that late game. It just starts getting more spread out, a little bit more chaotic as those commands come down, as the squad leaders talk over strategy. You know, send these guys out this way, send these guys out this way. It can be hard to remember where all the parts are moving, where everybody's moving to. You know, you might give your guys an order to push out west, and then you might get contact and forget you sent those guys out that way. So it can be kind of hard to organize these later game pushes here. So that's up to the squad leaders to talk that over and, you know, take control of their guys and get these guys synced back up into the pushes that they want.
Absolutely.
I mean, just going back to, and I've said it a couple of times now, like, HSG, just don't know if you've got Spooky there on his own. He's a squad leader on his own. You're not going to achieve anything like that, unfortunately. You know, running off, he's got no backup with his squad. I don't know where his squad is. He's just running out on his own, and you're just wasting a ticket every time you do that.
This is playing out very similarly to the last round.
Yeah, it definitely is.
In the grand scheme of things. WhiteFox pushed them all the way back to Nilrim. Garrett HSG, very, very, very roughly there. HSG pushes them back out. Now WhiteFox sneaking some guys back in around the backside again. Looks like they're going to try and cap Nilrim. And I think we might have another situation here. Pretty similar to last round, overall.
I can see HSG pulling back now through the forest out there to the west as WhiteFox moves into the cap. And there's still some downed HSG guys in there, so I'm sure they're monitoring that that cap and relaying that information back to their chain. And we got to get guys back in the cap. We're seeing that Elite Orange now leading the charge for HSG coming back into Nilrim.
Down to 144 tickets here for HSG.
237 here for WhiteFox. Pretty large disparity in the kills here, too. Either HSG with 55 kills, 129 deaths.
Yeah, that's just the way that the WhiteFox have set themselves up. They've been very good at pushing and wiping squads and the odd groups of three and four here and there.
Right.
You know, the ticket blade is coming into it, but with a kill to death ratio that HSG have got here, it's you can't deny that's what's changed the game.
Yeah.
I mean, it's, you know, it's not about kill deaths and everyone knows that, but unfortunately, taking this sort of a hammering on your tickets through the kills, it's detrimental.
Right. And in an extension to that, you put somebody like me in a squad that's effective and can communicate and cover corners, and even me, terrible at playing this game, is going to be able to get kills like that. So I think the kill death is more of a reflection of the tactics that each squad uses, and to, you know, what efficacy they can use those tactics, rather than a reflection of personal skill, which also does come into play. But I think people know what I'm talking about.
Definitely. And then when we come into this senior squad league and this tournament, it's coming down to team tactics and the way the team's set up.
Right.
Really reflects on how the game goes. You know, WhiteFox versus Redcoats last week, two very similar teams in the way that they move as units, you know, and that really, they sort of clashed heads down the riverbed because that's how they worked. You know, they didn't get spread out. They were meeting unit to unit, and that's why it was an extremely close game. Unfortunately, tonight's for HSG, they haven't matched that unit push.
You know, that's just the difference, too, between us and, you know, say something like a CSGO esports community. You know, it's much more player-based when you go over there. But for this, it's something I'm realizing is that squad is more, it's about moving pawns and moving pieces. And the better you can use your assets and those players, you know, the better team you're going to be for it. And that's what I like to see is it's not so much about the individual players, but it's more about the community effort, the teamwork movement. That we see, you know, the better you can use teamwork to your advantage, the better you're going to be at this game in terms of
definitely.
A team.
And what you find is that the top players aren't your top killers. They're the guys that are coordinating this team, you know, the guy that's driving the team on the comms. I mean, obviously WhiteFox are using TeamSpeak, you know, they're the guys who really shine in this game. They drive the team, you know, the Doc East of this world, the Prowlers. The Blitzers, you know.
Yeah, oh yeah, right.
You know, Hard Styles, all these clan leads that really drive the team. These are the ones that shine rather than your Twitch shooters who are, you know, getting 40 kills and 6 deaths. Yeah, they're very good, but they're not the ones who win you the game. WhiteFox managed to get Nilrems neutralized. I'm just seeing that now.
Yep, I am seeing that as well. We're 227 tickets here. Or WhiteFox. How's HSG looking? They've got to be getting pretty close to the 100 ticket mark.
111, so last 11 tickets.
The last 11 tickets here is coming into the final. Final few tickets here. Just a reminder, yeah, we will be doing a squad league key giveaway after the stream. So stick around for that. All you got to do is enter into chat. That'll throw you into the pool. And we will get a key out there to our community.
Seven tickets left for HSG.
Their militia there. WhiteFox capturing Nilrem. That's got to push HSG.
Two tickets.
Yeah, down very close there.
Last ticket. And that's game, 100 tickets.
Yep. Ask for some shit.
So congrats to WhiteFox taking third in our tournament overall. In today's matches up against HSG, we saw them take the first round and as well as the second round.
Yeah, very good round.
Yeah, absolutely, giving them the title of third in our tournament here. So stick around, guys. We'll be back soon with... stream will go cold right quick for about 10 seconds, so we'll start it back up live and do a live key giveaway, so stick around for that. And thanks for watching. Awesome matches there. And we'll have time and dates for our further events coming up shortly.